Mina, konnichiwa, Jesus Freaking Gamer here, back with more Dark Souls, back with some giant dad and some massive swag. Now, I did a few things, namely getting my ass handed to me by some PvP here. So this is Artorias' little area where you fight him. And I found a few things off to the side. And Robbie, Battle of Stoicism Gazebo. And Robbie mentioned that there's an area of, like, for PvP that no one uses. Dual dice. Team dice, deathmatch dice, the plaque of legends. Let's go ahead and peek out something. Reappear again, thank you. Deathmatch legends, what is this? Level 50 and below. Okay, so this is just apparently different people doing PvP here. Not a whole lot. He said not a lot of people used it. Really doesn't look very used to me either. And these are a bunch of developer messages here. Earn consecutive wins to be etched in the slate of legends. There are three types of battle of Stoicism matches: duel, 1v1, team, 2v2, and deathmatch. I guess a 4 free-for-all? It's not completely clear. Deathmatch ruins, team ruins, and duel ruins. So all sorts of interesting things there. So, was there anything in here that I missed? All that abyss that Artorias left behind. And the Lord's Blade Kieran, she dead. She's gone. Didn't leave much of anything left to her. She was a lot stronger than most of the NPCs outside of the DLC, though. Like, insanely stronger than them. And then the Royal Wood. Okay, so I probably came in through here. Let's do a little bit of exploring in the Colosseum for a little bit. For lack of a better term, this is the Colosseum. And there's nothing else around here. So, over here we go. There's a little something over there as well. That's the area where I just came from. What be upstairs? Well, actually, I know one thing that's upstairs. There is a door that I did not open. I was like, I felt kind of bad for going forward at all. So I was like, at the very least, I'm not going to go forward and look at the in the door or try to examine that off camera. In fact, I got an item while I was off camera. Where is it? The Purple Coward's Crystal, Exit Battle of Stoicism. Online play item, quit Battle of Stoicism, session ends if host leaves. Victory in this battle once led to ancient Anorlando, but even in the absence of its overseer, capitulation is a disgrace. In the name of a warrior's honor, do not quickly resort to use of this crystal. So I'm guessing, like, if you just don't want to PvP anymore, you do that. Oh, a loser just came in here. I just saw, man, my loser senses started going off the charts. And that door's locked. So apparently I need a key of some kind to access that. So continuing onwards, I don't think I'd continue very well onwards going down a giant pit of death. So we'll avoid that for now. Let me move my chair to the side. Make room for the loser coming in here.
Fuck off.
What's going on, Robbie?
Not much. Alright, so how far have you gotten?
I made zero progress in the last week. I devoted a ton of my time to my own personal character in this game.
Sir!
Yeah. So, if we can go straight to Gwyn, but I haven't done Manus. Haven't stocked up on humanity. I haven't explored this area at all. In fact, I ended up having to take care of some laundry. And
I am salty with you right now.
Well,
I almost brought you green tea from Panera, but I'm happy I didn't.
I didn't deserve it.
You don't.
Not at all.
I would have brought it and then started drinking it in front of you because of us.
I would have cried.
And flicked you all while I was in it.
Well, you already did that, so.
That's true.
That was already accomplished.
Y'all didn't see it.
He trust me. He gave me a nice little one of these right here.
Yeah, I called you number one.
The single digit
okay,
offensive.
Okay, so you haven't done anything here.
I haven't done jack.
All right. Yeah. Well, turn human.
Oh well, damn. Okay.
I came in at a good time.
Apparently you did. Where be my humanity? All right, giant dad's about to go. He's about to go human. Full human. I don't think there's a partial human in this anyway. So, okay, where to, GPS?
Keep going straight. Just keep going down the path.
Straight down here?
Yep, keep going.
Cool.
Just follow the path. I have decided from this point on, following into the next two games,
yeah,
I'm not going to be your complete GPS.
Oh, motherfucker hit me.
Good.
Haboosh. These guys are kind of strong.
Yeah, well.
You guys are a little on the stronger side. Good. So, in other words, a little bit of mindless wandering might do me good.
Yeah.
Oh, poopsicles. Oh, he pointed me out. Hi!
And laughed at you because you're fucking stupid looking.
That was brilliant.
They point and laugh at giant dads.
Apparently they do.
Because they can do that to you. And that. He is juking the hell out of you, man.
Okay, dude. You ready for some glorious spam? You're about to get some glorious spam. Go ahead and hit me, you motherfucking goddamn piece of shit.
He still dodged through one. These guys are champions.
These guys are pricks.
They're badasses, though.
Okay, I need 20 SS flasks. We're backing up here. Because apparently I did not do anything with this bonfire up here, so we're going to change that right now. Pop some humanities.
Yeah, well, yeah.
This is only a 5, so I need 3.
Man.
I'm about to get a shitload of humanities here with those humanity families coming up.
Man.
So it's going to be
cool. You didn't do anything.
No, I did absolutely nothing. Dude, this past week has been nuts. It's been absolutely fucking insane.
You still haven't uploaded another Fallout 4 video with you probably wandering around in the very last room of the vault looking at every pixel before you fucking leave.
And that's what's going to happen in Dark Souls 2 and 3 without you as a GPS.
Oh no, I'm still going to tell you when the fuck to get out of there, but I'm not going to show you where to go anymore. I'll just say, alright, you're done, Brandon. Fucking go! That's what I'll do.
Okay, that's how that's going to work from this point on.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because you've had it too easy in multiple regards.
I've had it far too easy?
Far too. You're using a stupid shit build.
Oh, I'm still going to use a stupid shit build in 2 and 3. If you don't tell me...
That stupid shit build doesn't really exist in 2 and 3. Oh, hi. No, you're not looking it up either.
Oh, yes, I fucking am.
Then I'm not coming anymore.
Okay, that totally is acceptable.
You can bite my ass.
I'd rather not do that. You're not exactly my type.
That's not what you said.
Shut up.
Yeah, see.
That was for no one else's eyes or ears. What are you doing? That's it. I feel like confidentiality has been breached here.
What a rude person you are. The person that got you into Dark Souls. Like, if you don't look anything up, or I'm not joining anymore. You're like, alright, fuck off. Like, what a rude individual.
Works for me.
You should all unsubscribe from him. He's an ass. You hear what this jerk just said to me? He was like, fuck off. I don't care if you join me anymore.
It's like, I can play the game on my own. Thanks for introducing it, by the way. Good game.
Yeah, well.
Like you said, you're not even here for me. You're here for the Souls games.
Yeah,
you said that. You said that at one point.
Yeah.
So like, I really don't feel a whole lot of obligation.
Well,
here.
I'm here to see someone play the Souls games for the first time through. Which you've had too much help on this one. Like I said, I'll still give you a general direction. I'm not gonna point you in the way of a build. I'm not.
And you said 2 is a lot more linear than this, which makes me think...
Well, past the first area. Like, once you get past the first area or two, then it's a relatively straight-on path.
Okay, gotcha.
But...
That just makes me think all the more so that, hi! That Miyazaki was not a part of it.
He wasn't.
Holy shit.
But,
Okay, Bloathead Sorcerer? These things are called?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can fuck off.
But, Oh.
Nope, I didn't get his mask.
No. Or the wand.
Yeah, or the catalyst, yeah.
Alright, so,
Oh, there's a thingy.
There's a thingy.
Oh, there's another thingy.
Yeah.
Hi, thingy.
But...
Goodbye, thingy.
Don't fucking look anything up. Like, don't! Like I said, alright. This is the thing. Okay, in Dark Souls 2 and 3, there are... no builds that are super popular, like Giant Death.
None that are super popular?
No, none that is going to garner views. None where people are going to go to YouTube and type in, any like, Giant Dad.
Or the legend Never Dies.
Or, yeah, something like that, and then videos pop up. There's not a super crazy build.
Okay, Wait, Marvelous Chester. Oh, hi, mate. Oh, shit. Your bolts are strong. This dude's not a fucking joke.
I wish we could get that kick move set, but you can't.
That would be cool. Nope. I have poise that can't... Oh, shit, look at that bleed.
He's a fucking badass, man.
That bleed!
It's those things that give you bleed, throwing darts.
Why is bleed going down so slowly?
Because bleed goes down slowly in this game.
Good gosh. I'm not gonna, this is like Priscilla, I'm gonna dick around right here.
Just two-hand it and run up!
As soon as my bleed meter goes away, I will.
Slam his butthole on the ground, he won't hit you, because he's gonna be like a pancake.
This dude is not a joke.
Look at Pancake Chester over there. Thank you, Pancake Chester. Alright,
so...
You can either continue, or we can go back and talk to him again, it's up to you.
What is advisable? I don't need to be human for anything else, right?
No.
Because I was like, if I die, then I can just go forward, that's fine.
Yeah, it don't matter, okay. But,
I see a treasure chest!
Man, you and me are gonna have like an hour-long argument on how you
can't
be looking shit up.
It's a fake! I don't much approve of that!
How'd that hit him?
Why not?
Because you turn the other direction.
That's his way, Hander. It's friggin' boss.
Yeah.
Oh, those cool little things that, you throw them.
Yeah.
And they actually say something.
Yeah. But, yeah, there aren't any, like, super popular builds. And that one that we saw a YouTube video on that was overpowered as bullshit.
Yeah.
In Dark Souls, I've never seen that before. And the reason I've never seen that is because it's not popular. It's not something that's going to garner a bunch of views.
Oh, really?
And
tell me where to use the sunlight maggot here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you passed it.
Oh, okay. Hold on. Did I aggro that motherfucker?
No.
No. Okay.
All right, but,
So it's somewhere...
No, you passed it by a long shot. Go all the way back to where you fought Chester.
Oh, okay. All the way back.
I'll tell you it's back there.
Back here.
No, back to where you fought Chester at.
I thought it was... Wasn't it on the staircase?
Nope.
Well, I retreated to the staircase is what I did. That's how I handled that situation. Okay, so this area right in here.
This is... Yeah, this is the general area.
Okay, so let's... Let's
now, you're not at the spot, but the way to get to the spot is from here.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's the whole thing. I just need... An illusionary wall here you can't actually tear down. You've got to have this thing.
Well, it's not this thing in particular, but this is one of the ways to do it.
Yeah, you need light of some
kind. Yeah, you need to create light.
And there's a developer... There's a dev message here somewhere that says that.
Yeah.
Going back around this way.
And there isn't anything like that in 2 either. There are weapons that are generally used by people because
they're good.
Generally, they're really good weapons. But
mm-hmm.
No one's gonna look up. Oh, Dark Souls 2 greatsword build. No one looks that shit up.
Because that's not. Giant Dad the only meme?
Giant Dad is the only meme build in the entire series.
Really?
Yes.
Huh. Thank you, Only Afro, for this amazing meme. I guess just drop down here.
Yep. He's the only meme build in the entire series.
I wonder how that happened. Why wasn't there a build in the other games that just became really popular?
I don't know.
I mean, I'm sure there are some good builds.
Maybe Afro Fucker got bored and just didn't make anymore.
Well, he's not the only one who created memes. I mean, gosh.
He's a big
That dude guy. Who did the... Now, hold on. Is that... Yep. There we go. Boosh! Kaboosh! And what a glorious treasure chest is... What glorious thing is going to be in this treasure chest? That has something to do with dark magic. Something-ish or other.
It's in the consumable items.
Oh, that's consumable?
I mean, it lasts forever, but you use it.
Okay, that's really weird. The archery carving says, very good. And anyway, let's read this while we're at it. Head carved of arch trees by Go in his imprisonment. Imprisonment? Go imparts an emotion to each and every completed carving, which helps him achieve personal enlightenment. Okay, so he's like, maybe he self-imprisoned himself. Brr. When a head is disturbed, it speaks, reflecting the emotion conferred to it. This head says, very good. Have another look. Does it not appear quite jovial? It appears incredibly jovial. Okay, where? There it is, silver pendant. Silver pendant engraved with the crest of Artorias, one of the ancient treasures of Anor'Londo, presented to Artorias for facing the Abyss. Effectively deflects the dark of the Abyss, especially in its magic forms.
So, if someone... this works for players, it works for NPCs, enemies, normal enemies, shit like that. Okay. If they cast a dark spell at you, you can use the item. It's on your quick select.
Okay.
Use it.
Okay, just use it right now.
If you use that in the general time that it would have hit you, it doesn't have to be an exact moment. If you hit it in the general time span that would hit you, it will deflect all dark magic spells.
Oh, so that's actually damn useful.
Yeah. That
someone's nearby. In
that deflection includes Black Flame, which is Giant Dad build. All right, you can take the maggot off if you want.
Oh, okay. Nothing else is near. Nothing else is to here.
Light.
Back to my swag gear. Oh hi. Where are you, buddy? You stopped.
He dicked off.
He did. He was just like, nope. I don't want none of that. And oh, okay. I didn't even need the second kaboosh.
You got buttons, hon. Gosh. That's a good fucking song. The song's actually shit.
Oh, is the song shit?
It's, well, it's by Nicki Minaj, so it's gotta be shit.
Oh, God. Oh, damn. I'm about to die, aren't I?
Is he heal? Yes.
Okay, so that's dark magic.
See, it, like, it takes a second to use. There you go. Shut up, okay.
Daggone. Oh, whoop. That wasn't an Essence Flask. Oh, so yeah, it just kind of bounces off of you if you time it right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I was like,
so,
I need
20 like, when
SS
you
blasts.
See them casting it, that's when you want to use it.
Ooh.
Not when the spell comes out.
Aw.
Yeah, someone's already looted this shit.
Yeah. I blame Chester.
Was Chester, to be completely fair, though.
I think that's a good person to blame. Okay, I see a ton of death. Is there a hidden mystery here?
There's a hidden mystery of death.
Oh, okay. It is the mystery of death that I see and nothing else.
Yeah.
Backing up to, I guess, here.
So yeah, like, there's no builds to look up in Dark Souls 2. I'm gonna finish this thought, it's the last fucking thing I do. There are no builds to look up for Dark Souls 2. There are gonna be people that go, hey, this is a really good build, I would recommend it.
Mm-hmm.
But there's nothing for, ultimate build, giant dad, there's none of that shit.
I'm guessing, based on what I saw in that one video, there's still some really overpowered
there
shit.
There are good weapons and good spells, but none of them are meme-worthy.
Ah, gotcha. I could just drop down for you.
That's where you just were.
Oh, okay. Then let's not do that.
Yeah, so there's nothing really to look up. If you were to look anything up on Dark Souls 2,
yeah,
it would be, or 3, it would be if you got lost. Which, like I said, okay. I'm not going to tell you where to go.
Mm-hmm.
But I will tell you where not to go. Like, you won't get lost when I'm here.
Okay.
But I'm not just going to tell you, hey, look out for mimics and go up staircase A, B, and C. I'm not going to do that shit.
Aha.
I did it in this game. I don't know why I did it in this game. I just felt sorry for you.
Maybe that's what it was.
But
it's very possible. Okay, yeah. I think I got lost.
You're done here, so you can just drop back down.
Drop down, I guess, here?
Well, that'd take you to death.
I thought I could roll across. I can't roll across.
No, just walk to the other side on that little bridge.
Okay.
And just drop down.
Oh, you
do.
Do it the easy way.
So yeah, I'll
drop
give you,
down where?
Walk to the end. I'll give you general direction.
Ah.
But that's about it. But like I said, there's nothing to look up in the next games.
Where to from here? Onto that little roof out there?
Yeah, that's a shortcut if you want to make the jump. Because progression is the way forward from here. So.
Oh, there's progression here?
No. I'm saying all that's left to do is progression.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
So if you want to jump to that roof, you can do a shortcut.
Okay, would a roll? No, that needs to be a full jump.
Yeah. So you'd have to go down the other side or right here.
Yeah, isn't it? The thing is right there. So if I take a running leap of faith. Hop! There we go. And staircase. Hop! Okay.
Why are you fucking Link?
Ha! Ha! Yeah! Ha! Ha!
That's.
Ha!
Alright, so...
Yeah!
Alright, so up is where you already were.
Giant Link. Okay, so up was where I was.
Yeah.
And then something tells me the chasm of the abyss would be down. Just get this Funny feeling.
Yeah, speaking of chasm, it's pronounced chasm. And the reason I'm saying that is because I actually don't know how that fucking hit me. Because he hit you.
The fuck?
How did that hit me? Oh, his hitbox connected with mine. What bullshit. But I actually don't know if it's pronounced go or golf.
Okay.
I actually have no idea. I think it's golf.
Poisoned. Oh, this whole area is full of bullshit. No. Well, then again, it's DLC, so I expect a decent
it's
amount
full
of
Dark
bullshit.
Souls.
Okay, so nothing over there. Keep moving down.
Yeah, Dark Souls 2, it's, I don't know how I feel about Dark Souls 2, because it has some absolutely terrible design choices.
Okay.
And some of the worst bosses in the series. Okay. But it also has some of the best bosses in the series. Like, I don't know how to feel about Dark Souls 2. I'm conflicted.
It's a mixed bag. Okay, come here.
Like, and some of them, like, some of the cool shit doesn't even require lore. Like, alright, well, I'm not gonna say anything about this boss, but his name.
Okay.
It's relatively early on in the game. He's called the Pursuer. Okay. There's next to no lore on this guy, but he's the coolest fucking dude I've ever seen. He's a fucking badass, but we don't know anything about him.
We just don't know anything about him. Oh, there's a lot of fuckers here. Holy shit.
There are quite a few.
Okay, we're gonna draw.
It's good for
that's good. That's
it's good for drawing.
Daggers or arrows or something.
Daggers?
Either
throwing knives. Okay, I thought you meant a dagger. I was like, how are you gonna fucking draw something with a dagger? But yeah, a bow would be a good decision.
I'll just step down here and then come back up. He'll come up the steps and follow me. Guys. Whoa, fresh meat. Daddy wants to play. I'm not there. They don't care. They're apparently not aggroing unless I go with them.
They're all being smart
and
waiting for you to aggro everyone before you aggro them.
Apparently. I don't take to intelligence very well. I don't appreciate that very much.
Well, I mean, you're a Christian, so.
Yeah. Have to deal with pieces of stupid shit like you.
And the rest of your church.
Okay, come here, dude. Oh, I don't have this weight hanger equipped. Yay, fantastic. Where'd he go? Come here.
Kill them all.
Come here.
Man, I thought I was gonna come over today.
And which is gonna be straight.
And it was gonna be Gwyn, and then we're done. That's what I thought was gonna happen.
That's what you thought was gonna happen. You were so wrong. You were so incredibly wrong.
God, I thought we were gonna finish the game today. Hopefully we will.
I'm debating that myself. Like, are we actually gonna have the time to do this?
I hope we will.
I hope so too. But life, man, life's busy. Well, you know, you're trained to be a police officer. You know.
I know all too well about the life of busyness.
Yeah, exactly. You're very familiar with that. Come on.
He is juking the shit out of your air. I said juking multiple times in this episode.
Apparently you did.
This is the first episode I've said the word juke, and I've said it like 3 times now. Like,
and why, I don't understand.
I don't know.
And
it became part of my vocabulary.
I don't think you understand, actually.
Actually.
Oh, hi there. Someone gives a shit. Didn't have a very good aim, but he's walking over. He's moving within range.
He's walking over.
No death.
Man.
That would have been
I was like, oh man, we're going to fight Gwyn.
It's
gonna be great, and then maybe we can play something else.
Nope.
But that's not gonna happen, I think. So what are we gonna do the Thursday after we finish this game? For those that don't know, I generally come over here on Thursday and we record normally like 2 or 3 weeks worth of episodes per session.
Pretty much. That is how it normally works.
That's how it normally works.
Oh shit.
Oh, he's poisoned!
Okay, come on, guys. Come on up.
Oh, God.
I have candy.
What? You got a van? Like, what is
this? I know, I don't have a van. I just have candy.
Candy and a van.
Candy and a van. Thank you. More health. This is going very slowly.
Well, yeah, it's because it's a clusterfuck room.
Pretty much. And I don't like being clusterfucked. I'm not a fan. Okay, let's go ahead and knock you out.
Alright, so the fact that he actually came The fact that he actually came down here...
Yeah?
...is a relatively rare occurrence.
How are you... Nope. Let's get the fuck out of here for now. Anything pursuing me?
Nah.
Nope.
It's relatively rare occurrence that he falls down.
Okay.
But it's actually good that he did.
Mm-hmm.
Because if he doesn't, the spot that you fight him on is a bitch.
Ah, gotcha.
So, it's actually probably for the best that he fell down. You can walk off there and slam him.
That's what I was looking for?
Yeah, the hitbox is a little wonky on the stairs, but you can do it.
Oh, I can't even fucking get... I can't even... I thought I could jump off. Apparently I can, too. Oh, there we are.
Yeah, like I said, it's a little wonky. Oh, he backed up. What a bitch.
Oh, shit. This could suck.
What a ballsack. Also, just so you're aware...
I was pretty smart to choose 20... Estus Flask.
Yeah, what's helpful?
That was a really good idea.
Just so you're aware.
Yeah?
Your room isn't as soundproof as we thought it was.
Okay.
Just so you know.
Okay.
Like, I can hear your ass outside.
Okay.
Alright, so.
Do-do-do. Lots and lots of abyss. Tons of abyss.
So, this is the shit that I'm gonna do, like, from now on.
Yeah?
Tell you, you missed an item and a door.
I missed an item and a door? Okie doke. Well, let's look over that. Actually, I'm going to take a peek out here first.
Oh, there's the item.
There's another item?
No, that's a light.
Oh, is that only a light?
Soul of a hero.
More souls. Yeah! And I came from up there. Where else can I go down here? Yeah, the bow enough is alone to weight me down. Is this illusionary wall area?
No.
Okay.
There's just an open doorway.
Oh, you know.
Don't know how you haven't seen it yet.
Oh, I miss open doorways all the time.
There you are.
I miss them all the time. That's a commonplace occurrence for Brandon.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yeah. That's the way I roll in third-person games.
Also, that's how you roll in first-person games. Oh, let me fucking read the same shit on Eternal 3 times. Let me diddle around in this room.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be glorious.
And say about 8 times in one episode. I don't know how long I've been in this vault.
Yep. Yep.
All right, so this is actually giving some time context to the people that are watching. At the time that we're recording this... is right after you started uploading Fallout 4. This isn't going to come out for a while.
Yeah, in comparison to where I am at the moment, yeah. A long while.
So, because you just released the Pinwheel episode.
I did, yeah.
That was a while. All right, so if you go back... I am going to tell you this. It's actually fucking weird. There, you do have to jump over the railing, like right behind you.
Behind me?
Like right there in that little room off to the right.
Mm-hmm.
You actually have to roll down there.
Oh, to get onto that.
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, and that was a mimic.
I actually completely forgot that was a mimic. I'm not even lying.
Well, that's okay. It was a 2-for-1 sale anyway.
Yeah.
So it don't matter. Ah, that little place where I was with our on Artorias' little Coliseum. I'll bet that's the key to that. Hi. Oh, is that where that leads? Sweet.
Well, that's the only locked door that was there.
So that...
Alright, don't jump down there yet.
Yet. Anybody? Oh, we got 2 options. We'll go out this door. Let's get my shield up just in case I need it.
Yeah. Alright, so this way has a drop that you cannot get back up from. The other way was a ladder.
Well, yeah, if I have to go that way and it's a drop, then I'll have to choose this area first. Going down.
Why'd you say that like you were Bugs Bunny?
Was that Bugs Bunny? I honestly even know who that was. To tell you the truth.
Alright, so there's a little thing there.
There it is.
Alright,
Wait, that's all?
Yeah, you had to knock that down.
Oh, okay.
Which you could have done earlier because you had a bow. Alright, now, you could either go straight off, or remember, there's like a spot that you could drop down off of that you just ignored. You could look up the ladder.
Spot I can drop down from up to there from here?
Well, I mean, it all goes to the same place. Like, back out the door.
I thought you said this was progression.
Both of them are progression. But this way has, I think, extra shit.
Okay, so a little bit extra shit here. Haboosh. We'll find out. We're heading down the right way. Or we're heading up the right way.
Yep, there's
that. Oh, there's an extra piece of shit. Give me that shit. Thank you. Appreciate it. Nice ass, too.
Okay. Hey, you're getting shit, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right, and then just drop.
It looks like a horribly long drop. Well, no, not if I go here. Now I just land on another little miniature rooftop.
Dumb shit.
Guilty as charged.
Man.
Okay, and so here is that.
It's kind of, like I said, it's kind of crazy because I'm playing through Fallout 4 at the same time you are.
Oh, wow.
But I'm playing through it with all the DLC and with mods.
Oh, nice.
And holy shit, is this game fucking hard, man.
Really?
I'm playing it the same way I did before, where I'm on survival with the brutality mod.
Yeah, I was about to ask you, whoa. Oh, that looks...
She goes down far, far ways.
We're literally heading into the abyss.
Yeah.
That's pretty much what we're doing here.
Yeah.
What exactly... Did I already go through
nope.
there?
Nope.
I did not.
Nope. There's an elevator.
Ah. See if that does something cool.
It's going up.
Let's see if this does something interesting. Well, I guess it's interesting enough.
So you may recognize this area.
It looks incredibly familiar to me. As in, like, where I fought Artorias and stuff.
Nah. This is...
If I go up enough, it'll be where I fought Artorias.
Well, that's...
And I need to unlock that door, and apparently Hawkeye goes behind that door. So let's do that.
Yeah, so the left, that's like an arena.
Yeah, and you said, this is the PvP thing you were talking about that no one uses, apparently.
No one fucking uses it.
Like, no one gave a shit when they released it.
No.
It was just like, no shit's given.
Everyone was like, oh, there's an arena, but there's also an area that we can invade in.
Yeah.
Let's go with the invading one.
So.
Now, Dark Souls 2 has an arena that people actually use.
Aha.
I've never used it, because I prefer invading.
You prefer invading?
Yeah, because it's more of a dick move.
Do you like being a dick, Rob?
I do.
Is
You're
it
OG.
Fun?
All right, but...
Hi!
Hello, sir.
That is a giant, if any have gianted.
A visitor, have
that
we?
Voice.
Thou must be the one who freed Artorias.
Playing with the
fact that old friend he was. Thanks to thee, he left this world with honor intact. And here I am, retired and blind. Of little help to thee, I'm afraid.
For an archer to be blind, that's pretty bad.
He didn't used to be blind.
Well, I would imagine not.
Yeah.
Being Hawkeye go.
Of course, him being blind doesn't really mean much.
Not if he shoots down Calamite. No, it doesn't.
It's a fucking true-ass shot, too. It's good.
I know the giant blacksmith sells large titanite shards as well. I didn't think they were 3,800 souls, though.
I think they're the same.
Are they the same?
I know the dude in Sense
Goes
Fortress.
Goes great arrows.
The dude in Sense Fortress sells them for 4,000. Which is more expensive.
Oh, large titanite shards are 4,000 there?
Yeah.
Oh, in that case, that is more expensive.
So let me look up the giant blacksmith.
So I found the thank you carving. And so then there's the hello carving. This head says hello. Have another look. Do you sense the amicability in its eyes? No, not really. Sorry. And that prism stone reminds me.
Giant blacksmith also sells it for 3,800. So it's the same price as both of them.
Okay, so it's fucking expensive wherever you get it. Gotcha. Prism stones remind me, in my personal playthrough on my other character, I found the blue titanite slab.
Oh, yeah.
And that is not a straight walkway. That's a bitch.
It is. Which is why I didn't take you down it.
And not only that, I'm not going to use a magic or an enchanted weapon. So
that's
It was pretty pointless. But I did find it nonetheless.
It's a pain in the dickhole.
Let's see what else.
The vast secret to explore this domain. be wary of a black dragon. I fear thee no match for this terrible beast.
I don't know about all that.
Because you're a little bitch.
Me? There's very little to be said.
His voice.
What is a dog with no hairs to hunt? But I'm lucky to be alive, I suppose.
I'm glad I have subtitles on. There is no fucking way I could understand
that. I don't
even
think you can turn subtitles off in this game, can you?
I don't know.
I don't think you can. I know they're on naturally. I know we didn't change a setting to turn them on. I know they're on by default.
Yeah.
But I don't know if you can even turn them off.
Now I'm kind of curious.
I kind of want to know.
Me? There's
okay,
farewell, human. Lead thy life as thou seest fit.
I was planning on doing it just that. Thank you kindly, sir. Damn that bow.
Right?
And I can wield that? How the fuck is a little midget like me going to wield that?
It's funny, because he actually says something to that effect.
How the fuck? I mean,
he's like, I don't even know if a human can use this shit, but here you go. That's...
So, nothing, no new dialogue at this point in time.
Not yet. But so, we're not going to progress just yet.
Just yet?
The first thing we're going to do is go back and talk to Marvelous Chester.
Okay, he has new dialogue.
The guy that invaded you.
Yeah, because he was like friendly before, then he invades the shit out of me. I'll be very curious to hear what he has to say. Wouldn't he remember invading me? I mean, mm-hmm. I was like, wouldn't that be a thing he would know about?
Yup.
So let's go back to him.
I mean, if you want,
I have no idea where the fuck he is.
Well, if you want to heal up your Estus flasks, there.
Well, what I was thinking was, I've already killed
There's
a lot of
enemies. There's nowhere to teleport to get closer to him. This is the closest bonfire to him.
I've already killed a lot of enemies in the area, though, so...
If you don't, okay. So go back, then.
Go back?
Yeah. Well, I mean, remember... Killing all the enemies in the area doesn't matter, because you now have an elevator back to the point where you stopped.
Well, no, that's true, too. Hmm.
Well, we're gonna die anyway. Just keep going.
Just keep going?
You're gonna die anyway.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, the NPCs in the DLC are not a joke. That's
really no, he's sure. Probably not gonna go.
Oh, it's gonna be something else. Nice. I'm looking forward to my... However many fucking deaths it's been at this point. Okay, and I didn't explore this area at all.
There's nothing here to explore, honestly.
Nothing?
There's a nice view.
And there's the Ulaseel Township.
Would you actually die down there? You can see your bloodstain from here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's tight. I do love the way it's like one continuous environment. That
yeah,
is really
seriously
cool. I love
that shit.
Cool.
No load screens. I fucking love it. Unless you die.
Well, yeah. Now, I do kind of wish they'd streamline the die thing so it would be quicker.
Alright, so it's that way.
It's over here. So across the bridge.
Yeah. Which
yonder I rode.
All the games are like that, except Dark Souls 2's use of space is a little fucked up, but whatever.
Okay, dude.
Oh, you. You have quite some nerve. Or are you just thick? Fine, then. What is it that you need?
You attacked me, sir. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, he's like, I've shown you that I don't like you, and you're still coming trying to fucking talk to me, dumbass.
Did you really slay Knight Artorias? I'd heard the Abyss found him first, but even still, that's absolutely treacherous. Yes, magnificently so.
Interesting. He sounds like he's disapproved, but then he's like, that's kind of cool. Interesting weirdo.
Believe it or not, Ulaseel has brought the Abyss upon itself, fooled by that toothy serpent. They upturned the grave of primeval man and incited his ornery wrath. What could they have been thinking? But to you and I, it's all ancient history. You have to ask yourself, does it really matter?
Okie dokie.
That's so interesting.
So, Toothy Serpent.
That'd be Darkstalker Koth.
That'd be Framped.
Would it be Framped?
Be Framped. So, basically, when Gwyn...
More time.
Yeah, when Gwyn did his shit, the Serpents were like, oh, this place is fucked up. I'm gonna go do shit. Let's go do shit.
Hmm.
Other Serpent guy. Koth went to New Londo and was like, hey guys,
You know what you should do? You should kill each other for humanity. And then dark raids happened.
Yeah.
Frant went to Ulysseal and was like, hey guys, you know what you should do? You should dig up Manus for his humanity. So they did it, and then everything got fucked.
So you would really accuse both of them of doing some fucked up shit.
Oh, yeah!
So they're both pretty fucked.
They're both pretty big assholes.
What is the... Do you...
Cause, well, and it makes sense, because, alright, Koth's intentions. He wants for the Abyss to take over. He wants for humans to rule.
Yeah.
So he was like, humans kill other humans so you can get stronger, so that you can rule everything. Koth was like, alright, I don't want the Abyss to take over everything, so I'm gonna go have these guys fuck themselves up so they can't stop Gwyn. Makes sense. Because, you know, Frampt is sucking Gwyn off, Koth is sucking himself off. It'd be kind of hard with his teeth, but, I mean, I guess it's possible.
I guess he manages.
Yeah. Use your gum or something.
That's...
So, yeah, that's the lore behind Frampt and Koth's blowjob abilities.
Why is this series a thing? Moments like this just make me wonder. I just released yesterday the whole Ghost Semen title.
I noticed that.
Yeah. Just for you, my good, good friend.
It's what it looked like he was doing. It looked like he was jerking off ghosts. All his arms wiggling about in a jerking motion.
Ah, jeez. And also, that kind of brings up the point. If Manus is the primeval man, does that make him the furtive pygmy?
Yes. It's not confirmed. Miyazaki hasn't been like, hey, yeah, Manus is a primeval man. Pretty much everyone accepts that Manus was a primeval man.
And what that makes me think
or
is...
Or the furtive pygmy.
Because every single creature in this game has a soul. But the soul is used to power yourself up and used for currency. It is not humanity. That's something very, very different.
Humanity... Alright, so souls are basically power in this game. Souls are seen... Everything that's alive has a soul. Trees have souls. Gods have souls. Humans have souls. They have power within them. Humanity is what we would perceive as a soul. It's something that's unique to humans to make that glump of meat a person. So humanity is what we would call a soul. Souls are what we would call, like, power. Manus... He's referred to as the father of the Abyss.
I've heard that title. I forget where,
which,
but yeah.
Basically, like, I don't see any other outcome from him being the first human. He created the Abyss. Which the Abyss is just... We'll see the Abyss later in sentient forms. And they're literally just humanities. Just giant humanities.
Yeah.
That are just physical amalgamations of the Abyss. That's all they fucking are. If you read the description of a humanity, it actually, I think it mentions something about the, I think. I don't fucking know. Maybe that's Dark Souls 2. Well, Dark Souls 2 don't really have humanity. Whatever, we'll get into that later.
Yeah.
But, and Manus's soul is different from every other human soul. So we know he's a human, because he's referred to as the primeval human. But his soul... is still affecting shit in Dark Souls 2 and 3.
His soul
is still affecting shit. Just the existence of his soul is still doing stuff. So, there's something about him, and most people I know of that are in the Dark Souls lore community...
Yeah.
Basically, have come to the conclusion that Manus is the furtive pygmy.
Okay.
He was the birthplace of all humans, so...
The Abyss gave birth to humanities.
Yes.
And humanities are, you're saying, essentially the souls of humans specifically. Whereas everything has a soul, everything has a life force. There's a more specific life force for humans, and that is the humanity. And the Abyss and Manus are the birthplaces and the origins of humanity.
Perfect.
Which means, as a chosen undead, I'm actually going up against fucking Adam.
Pretty much. Essentially,
is what I'm doing. And why is the Abyss so fucking dark? And that also begs the question, though, why can't humans traverse the Abyss? Why do I need the Covenant of Artorias as a human to traverse my birthplace? That makes no sense.
Why wasn't Adam allowed back in the Garden of Eden?
Well,
I mean, because shit went bad and God went, fuck off. That's why.
But that's assuming...
It's kind of the same thing here. Darkness... Humans came from darkness... But darkness can also consume them. I'm trying to think of how to word this. It is odd, because... Koth talks about how bringing in the Abyss will bring in the age of humans. But we've seen in Ulysseal, in this DLC, the Abyss is still bad for humans.
Yeah.
But it's not bad for humanity. It's bad for their physical bodies. But humanity lives in the Abyss. Humanity are little chunks of the Abyss that have gained sentience. In a sense. So really, the Abyss isn't bad for humans. It's bad for humans' physical form. Like, the Abyss wouldn't destroy their soul, but it would destroy their body. In a similar way to, like, our human bodies aren't allowed in heaven. But our soul is.
That's an interesting analogy from a Japanese game.
If you want to look at it like that.
I'd rather honestly think of it in terms of the native religious nature of the author of this work. I mean, he clearly made this game with a worldview in mind.
I don't know what his religion... Let me fucking look this shit up.
I wouldn't immediately go to a Christian worldview for a Japanese game. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we're talking about a fictional universe here. We're not talking about reality. I mean, you know, I can come up with a universe complete with gods and layers of reality in different dimensions.
I'm just trying to draw parallels into something that we can understand.
And that's why I'm really interested to hear, like, where the author Miyazaki himself is coming from. Because his worldview is definitely... Or if he made up his own worldview, just completely made it up. I'd be much more interested in hearing his story and his take on how all of these elements... intermingle.
Alright, well, you do your shit. I'm gonna look this up.
Well, you've quite the nerve. I've had enough of you.
Okay, before you, like, fucking attack me, do you have any shit that I want to buy? He has a humanity. He has one humanity. Or does he have more? Oh, he has more.
Alright, so... Miyazaki refuses to get into the topic of religion. He's been asked about it primarily because most of his games, such as Dark Souls, involve specifically humans interacting with deities.
Yeah, well, yeah. Conclusion.
Yeah, so a lot of people have asked him about his religious stuff, and he won't go into specifics, but he has stated that he dislikes and distrusts the notion of religion.
That is incredibly fascinating.
Yeah.
Considering the way his stories are themed, that's fascinating.
Which, well, I mean, think about it. In this, let's take Dark Souls for an example.
Okay.
In this, yeah, there are the gods, and there's Anor Londo and all that fancy shit, but it's all a lie.
Yeah.
You get there, it's all bullshit. They've been lying to humans for however long, you know. Yeah. And, you know, like, makes it relatively obvious in this and in later Souls games that gods... While they're more powerful than humans, for the most part, they're generally pieces of shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, if he distrusts religion, well, what better way to say that than go, I'm putting religion in this game, and it's going to be lying to you.
That is incredibly fascinating. That's actually one of the reasons I like Final Fantasy X so much as a game. Because of the spoiler alert, if anyone hasn't finished Final Fantasy X at this point in history...
Final Fantasy X gets into... Final Fantasy as a series gets into organized religion shit.
I've heard that said about the Final Fantasy games, and to an extent, but a very small extent, I can agree, but Final Fantasy X is all about religion. Mm-hmm. That's at the core message of the story.
Yeah.
And the whole thing is, yeah, it's bullshit.
Yeah, it is.
It's all wrong. And Final Fantasy X is my favorite Final Fantasy out of them all because of that story arc.
Really?
Isn't it interesting how I'd probably be considered a very devout religious person.
Stupid ass motherfucker.
Well, beats the alternative. So,
give me the fucking...
It's really interesting...
Take the piss, Lord. All right, continue.
It's really interesting how Final Fantasy X and games like that just... They don't offend me at all. They fascinate me.
Yeah.
I love to look at that stuff and think about it. It gives me reason to pause and reflect on real life. And that's the best kind of fiction. Something that makes you actually stop and think.
Yeah.
I love works like that. And I have to, despite the indirect, fucking vague-ass storytelling in this game, the lore still interests me.
Because it's fucking
just
cool.
Like the lore in Five Nights at Freddy's interests me. It's
I mean, that's a shit series.
It's so vague as fuck, but it's interesting.
That fan, though.
Why do people talk about the fan so much? Okay.
All right, so...
You're gonna go hostile on me, Chester?
No, but he has no other use at this point. This is the moment where I kill him in every fucking...
Well, Ivan, I'll be seeing you if you survive your travels.
Like, why does this guy hate me? That makes no sense at all. I've literally done nothing to this smiling bastard.
He's a shit stain.
He's a shit stain?
Yeah.
Is that all he is?
Pretty much.
Well, let's put him out of his misery. Which is not going to be easy. I saw someone fight this motherfucker. And all the NPCs in this game have an absurd amount of health.
Now, I would say that he's actually easier in this form than he was when he invaded you.
Okay.
But
haboosh.
What now? You think this is all my fault? How very, very petty of you. Very petty indeed.
You think?
Basically, it's called you a little bitch.
Essentially.
Oh!
There.
Having an orgasm over there, killing you.
Apparently.
You win. Please. Oh, please. Have mercy.
What is up with this guy?
He's okay. Fucking cool, though. He's marvelous.
And now for Chester's set.
Man, that top hat is probably the sexiest piece of gear in this entire fucking game.
It probably is.
It's a beautiful... Like I said, I joined games wearing nothing but that fucking top hat.
And I'll say, it's so... Actually, let's read...
I also what I do, which is a giant dick move, is I... I do this specifically in Elysium. Because
okay.
Really late game, I'll go through there and fish for invasions. Like, I'll just walk around with humanity on.
Yeah.
And people invade me. I'm wearing, like, starter knight gear. I have a fucking heater shield and a long sword. Going through it, and people are like, oh, look, what a little bitch. And they think they're gonna, like, fuck me up. And I'm sitting there, and I'm just back. Like, I don't attack them. I just kind of cower in the corner until they finally come up and hit me. I parry them. Pull out a demon's great axe. And just beat the shit out of them. It's amazing. It's... I saw it on a YouTube video once. I forgot what fucking video it was. But I saw it, and I was like...
That's funny!
I was like, that's the best idea I've ever seen in my life.
That is shit. So funny. Because then you just... I mean, they're already staggered horribly after being parried. You just R1 spam them to death.
Oh, no!
Thing.
If you take it out fast enough, you can get a riposte off with the Demon's Great Hammer, and that's a one-hit kill. Unless they have, like, 50 vitality.
Oh, my gosh.
It's crazy.
That thing is strong.
I think once it's fully upgraded, it has S scaling and strength.
So. Gotcha. You get like 50, 60 strength on you, that thing is going to wreck some shit.
Fuck someone up.
The snickering top hat. Black top hat worn by Marvelous Chester, a man of mystery, lost in the past. The wearer of this top hat cracks a dubious, permanent grin. The curse of Chester.
I love this guy.
Chester's long coat. Black leather long coat hat worn by... Long coat hat? What? I'm just like, wait, what?
Japan.
Right. A long coat hat?
Long coat hat worn
by... Worn by Marvel...
That's amazing.
What the hell? So his leather long coat hat, worn by Marvelous Chester, a man of mystery lost in the past. This exquisitely sewn aristocratic suit allows its wearer to move in silence, lending well to stealth. So this is... So
it's a nice looking suit, too.
And a man of mystery lost in the past, that's the same all the time. Oh, it's not leather gloves hats? Oh, doggone.
Leather gloves hat worn by Marvelous Chester.
I was waiting for it. I was ready. These gloves have no distinguishing features, but are of extremely high quality. And Chester's trousers. These exquisitely sewn trousers are decorated with silver trinkets of varying sizes and have straps on the inner legs for carrying crossbow bolts.
You're not British.
It feels so appropriate reading it that way.
It does,
for this particular armor set. I think I quite like it.
Beautiful.
I quite like it. But let's face it, it ain't nearly as swag as this right here.
No, that's a lie, and you know it.
There isn't,
that, you look like a giant bitch, baby.
You can't out-swag the giant dad.
So, go down the left.
How about we get the item first? Or actually, this is
down the left.
I'll say, actually, it continues down into another path.
Yeah. Alright, now when we get down here, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna turn around and go backwards.
Okay.
So turn around.
Oh, like right now?
Yeah, and go the opposite way. Like, not up the stairs. Go back that way.
This area is... What the hell is that?
That's abyss poop.
Huh. That's... Well, no, it's just this land is overridden by the abyss.
Yeah. You saw this giant... Oh, did you ever go back and get the armor set back in that other area?
Which one?
The stone.
No, I haven't returned that area at all.
Oh my god, Brandon.
Not at all.
I feel like I'm gonna make a food trip while you're fucking farming for humanity and getting armor.
Okay, yes, come at me both at once, guys. And that guy, he refuses to get close. Okay, so they don't have a ton of HP.
These are abyss dogs.
They don't have a ton of HP, they're just very fast. Okay, so another thing I'm gonna do, Hickey, over here.
You know, I kinda want.
What do you
I kinda want to order a pizza.
That's an interesting thing. Why do you want to order a pizza, good sir?
I don't know. I just do. I'm in a pizza mood.
Boosh. There we go. You should get one then. I mean, if you want one, why not? Anything else? No, not in that direction anyway, I doubt it.
You want pizza.
I'll think about it. Maybe.
Do I even have cash on me?
Now that's a very good question. That is worthy of asking. You know what? This episode's pretty much over, so let's end it here.
What the fuck? My wallet just, like, almost cut me. I think there's a card sticking out of it or something. It, like,
that's
almost gave
weird.
Me a paper cut.
Gee whiz.
I have to get a new wallet.
Oh, wait, hold on. I see a literal bitch dicking up to me. So let's,
Bitch, Dickie, that's an oxymoron.
Isn't it? Boosh. And on that note, thank you guys very much for watching this video. If you liked it, hit that like button. And if you disliked it, hit that dislike button. And if you really like it, be sure to share with a friend, subscribe, and join the freaks!
Pizza souls!
I love you, and God bless.